Welcome to Comfort Havoc number 2. I'm going to do one Mass Effect video. I'm going to do the Asari Arc mission, and I'm going to talk about anything but this Asari Arc mission. So you're going to hear that over me, and you know, I want to talk about some stuff about Mass Effect Andromeda and how sad I am that we didn't get a DLC, and how sad I am have been ferociously searching for the last 3 days for Mass Effect Annihilation, because if you want to know what happens to the Quarian Arc, you have to read the goddamn book. Which BioWare has dropped the ball on that. So, without further ado, we're going to set this computer up over here and get everything straight so you guys can see what's going on. I'm going to be a killjoy on this fucking light here. Try to get the whole TV and screen. I'm also a female writer, just in case anyone cares. Which I'm sure you don't. So, this is the only mission I'm going to do. I don't carry my butt to bed. I have class tomorrow. Probably need to put my glasses on. Let's go old school, because the other glasses are still in the backpack from school tonight. And we're going to do this now.
We're aboard. Any response to comms?
Nothing.
Maybe so, their sensors are busted.
For all of those Mass Effect fans who, like me, actually liked Mass Effect Andromeda and think that it was, like, awesome. Like, I think it was freaking awesome. And I think that we got ripped off and should have been able to get a DLC. Instead of having to go read the book, I'd much rather be able to do this and run down there and enjoy it. You know, because that would be like a great thing to do.
Die, you cat monsters. We're not cat. We're a Pathfinder team. Ryder,
also, I'm having some control problems.
Sam, just send her our identity.
Confirmed. Sorry. I'm Captain Atandra, but what's left of the Lucinia. Come up to the bridge. Maybe you can help fix this mess.
Maybe you open the damn door. Anyway, that being said, you know, I really think that I shouldn't have to pay yay so much money for a damn book. And I'm not really big on reading. I mean, I'll read the book because I really want to know what the hell happens to the Quarian Arc. But at the same time, you know, there's something seriously wrong with this damn controller. At the same time, I'd much rather play the DLC. But since we are not getting a DLC, and BioWare should honestly, truly to God, be ashamed of themselves, because Andromeda's not a bad game. The Social Justice Warriors screwed that up. I mean, they literally set out to ruin this game. And I'm going to tell you how they ruined it. First off, they decided that the girl who they modeled Ryder after was too beautiful. And that no woman in the future should have the beauty that the young actress that plays Ryder, the body image. Not that Miss Wolf, who talks for Miss Ryder, isn't very beautiful herself. You guys can Google them. They are very beautiful women. The model, who is of Latin-ish descent, and the actress, who is of European descent, both are very, very beautiful women. Miss Wolf's last name is the only part I remember about her, because she's the voice. While the actress, I can't remember at all. And, you know, usually a man doesn't forget the name of a beautiful woman, but hey, I'm old.
Yes. We can't take any more chances.
And FYI, I generally play this the same way. But yeah, I mean, honestly, I think we were ripped off by BioWare about a DLC. And I think that we should have got one for just for the sake of,
Cora here thought the famous Sarissa would have everything in hand.
I thought Matriarch Ashara was Pathfinder, ma'am, and you were her bodyguard, like her Tiamat. I served with the Sarissa commandos, ma'am. Memorized all
this
your
is like
battle, ma'am.
Some serious bad fan feedback, because, you know,
was next in line.
When the endings came out
battle
in Game 3,
kept the cat
they swiftly gave us a Leviathan DLC, and they swiftly gave us the Omega DLC.
What happened?
What did you guys forget that? Now, it might be me because I have a PlayStation. I am PlayStation all day. I don't know how it worked for the Xbox, but for the PlayStation 3 at the time that they released Mass Effect 3, because it was the first game I bought, when I destroyed the entire universe, including all life in the universe, because I hadn't played the second one or the first one, and then the first one didn't come out until they released the whole trilogy for the PS3. So then I went back through it, and I kept playing it, and kept playing it, and kept playing it. And sometimes I still go back and keep playing it. As you guys have been watching this channel, you know that on my Facebook page, I have dropped some mad old school Mass Effect, because I kept my word about while promising.
You pissed off the kid and endangered your arc for a map.
But then, you know,
well,
top that off.
Running military ops since your ancestors were children.
The whole
here we are.
Flip-flop thing about that is that, you know,
what would it take to get the arc?
I had to go back and visit old school Mass Effect because, you know, they haven't given us any intel or feedback on what they're going to do with Mass Effect. And I know out of 1,000 people, I'm not the only one who wants a Mass Effect DLC. I personally want a sequel to Andromeda and a sequel to that. I would like Andromeda to be a trilogy too, just to wrap it up. And then start from scratch with a brand new, whole different concept, either deep in the future or maybe a First Contact war game. Maybe something that's awful new where they can bring both universes together. So that the pure humans, and depending on what the hell you chose for the ending of ME3, could, you know, be decided.
You okay, Cora?
Because, you know,
the
supposed endings from Mass Effect 3 were leaked, so you only got four possible endings. You don't get a big boss battle like it was promised for those who were on the Xbox. If you do a little bit of reading and some deep diving, there was a promise of a boss battle in Mass Effect 3. Outside of the two you have with the damn Reapers, because you kill one Reaper with the worm, and you kill the other Reaper with the big gun, one on T'Chanka, one on Rannoch.
Was it this quiet when
and so,
the Ents were traveling through dark space?
You know, they promised a boss battle for everybody who had an Xbox. They didn't really say much of a spot for the PlayStation 3, except for after you bought the first game and the second game, they promised the trilogy, and you got the trilogy, and most of the trilogy, if you didn't buy the main game like I did, the game 2 came with everything, I mean literally everything. It came with the DLCs already on the game, Zaid and everyone else, and when I bought the game, I didn't have to go get DLCs until after I beat the game, and they came up with the Leviathan and the Omega DLC.
Stop.
Or Afterlife, whatever you want to call it.
Shoot your
so I'm thinking, you know, BioWare kind of dropped the ball, and they really should have gave us a DLC for this. They should have let us know what happened to the Quarians.
This is my team.
And I was watching something else, and you know, I think it's a guy I follow. His video is at least 3 years old. And he said something about the Quarian arc, and he said that the Nexus, I think that's the name of this place that you go back to visit. That there was only four portholes for the arcs to plug in and power up. And since the Quarian ship was missing, how would they use the fourth porthole? But he neglected the fact that the Torian ship is the only ship that gets totally destroyed. So the Corian ship does have a place to dock.
No.
And that's the thing about this, you know. I seem to feel like I'm the only faithful Mass Effect fan who still buys for that DLC. And BioWare, if you're listening, I need a job and I can write a little story here and there and we can fix all of this with the DLC. Hell, even a sequel game. Maybe in a DLC you can start us off as the Quarian Pathfinder to handle the problem. And then, you know, eventually bring in Ryan, whichever Ryan you choose to bring in. And then fix that little issue. You know, because that's a thing. But I know that a lot of people are like me, and that might be a bit too much like the right thing to do. Kate! We've
got this. Cover the console while Sam works. Nice, steady fire. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you know, it kind of sucks ass. My controller is seriously fracked up, people. I think that's just like all my controllers seem to have this issue. Damn it, that's not what I wanted. Not what I'm supposed to do.
Giving shield assist.
That's more like what I'm supposed to do.
That's up to 70%.
And I have no grenades. Took off.
What was that?
I estimate that several of the arc's electrical junctions just overloaded.
Daria? Daria, Sam says we lost some electrical junctions.
Yeah, what do you guys think? Do you think that,
that shouldn't have happened.
They dropped the ball?
Soldier,
don't think that after 2.5 years we shouldn't get a DLC? We shouldn't have to pay like 15 or 20 bucks for a book?
That
we could just
big?
Play the game instead of read? Come on, computer.
Theories can wait, people. Let's secure the Ark first. That might be complicated.
Let you know.
Ket,
I mean,
the
way I see
it, if they delay
it
the repairs long enough, the Valiant ship catches up.
But, I mean, that's just my personal feelings. I honestly think that both Riders and them deserve the same fair shot that Shepard got. Because, you know about Shepard as soon as you start playing. You know that Shepard's a war hero, a ruthless, or a soul survivor. You got those three choices. With this character, you actually get to build your lore, which is great. Okay, granted, the Renegade and Paragons need to come back, but for the most part, you're virtually neutral, but every choice does have a consequence. And, you know, some of them just really ain't worth making, really.
Ryder, it's Sarissa. We got some power, then a damage report. What happened?
An accident. We're fixing it.
All right, go forward. We'll keep prepping the drive core.
We won't let you down, ma'am.
Of course not, Lieutenant. Sarissa,
but, you know, I mean, everybody's entitled to their own opinion. Maz did. I honestly think that we deserve better. Because, you know, we invest into these characters, we invest into our feelings, and all around, we just love this game. Now, if you're not a Mass Effect Andromeda fan, I don't hold it against you. I think you should probably give the game another chance. But that's just me.
An evacuation order. Someone
must believe me,
they
when they dropped the ball on the third game, when they dropped the ball on the endings of the third game, oh, I was pissed. Because I was looking forward to that boss battle. And I'm sure everybody who had an Xbox was looking forward to that boss battle. But some ass had leaked out the information of how the game was supposed to end. So they gave us four pussyfied ass endings. And I'm sorry if the word pussy offends people, but it's the truth. They gave us some pussy-fied ass endings. It's like someone stuck anthrax in a tampon and jammed it up my ass.
Watch your step. Now,
and I say that lovingly with no disrespect to females in general, but you know, they would know how that feels. Now, especially when you invest so much time and energy into the game. And then, you know, DLCs aren't exactly cheap. I mean, not everybody has $10. And some DLCs are higher than that. Just depends on the game. But, you know, you have to, where the hell is my weapon? How do I get my weapons? I forgot how to get the weapons. Okay, that's not how to get the weapons. God damn it. I don't understand why I can't remember how to get the weapons. No, damn it.
I'm almost at the stasis pods. Ah, blasted. No power for elevators.
Vidaria, cut the elevator's mag locks. If the arc's like ours, you can climb down the shaft.
Good idea. Thanks, ma'am.
I can't summon them back either. Because I don't remember how.
So many people.
But yeah, you know, I really think that they ought to give us some more content.
The cat did that to them.
I think that they really dropped the ball.
That's Cerise's last name.
And that they should have, crap. And that's the thing, yeah, sorry, I would have kept talking, but I got slightly distracted by two of those things there. I want to switch my gun to my light and my small arms. You guys are going to go back and watch that and see that this cat was not blown over there at first. I swear both of them fell together, but no computers and glitches and games.
Vidaria again. Two cat were trying to mess with the stasis pods. Not anymore.
Good work. Remember Cerise's manuals. Stay low.
I will. The pods are safe. I'll keep tracking that power drain.
Again, you know, I mean, I watched the video earlier today before I went to class about how they may possibly revive the original trilogy with today's technology. And I'm going to tell you one thing, I'm actually down with that because I would love to see what Shepard could do with a scanner.
And then reach whatever's draining power without getting singed.
And a jump jet. I mean, if Shepard had a jump jet and scanner, boy, he'd be dangerous. Or she'd be dangerous. Guess it just depends on which one you would prefer. I will not lie to y'all, I prefer FemShep. She has more options. That pretty much sounds as bad as it did, but it also is true. Male Shepard has great options, but when it comes to like the romance of the game, FemShep's romance seemed to be a little bit more thrilling, so to speak. And I just like FemShep. Psychedelic pervert in me likes to, see boobs. Of course, as bad as I am, there are some people who are far worse than me when it comes to Mass Effect, because we have seen on certain PCs that people are running around with FemShep naked. Like I said, psychedelic pervert in me. No, I'd run around with FemShep naked too. I'm not gonna accuse somebody else of something that I would definitely do myself.
The electrical junction is damaged. I recommend searching for an alternative.
But you know, I am honest about it, and I watched the videos with FemShep in anything but clothes.
Can't see a way to fix it. Any luck, Ryder?
But you know, not everybody is as honest as me. And I might be too honest for my own good. But yeah, you know.
This powers the Arcane's fire control more. There. Let's try again.
FemShep. Naked. I'm down. Although whoever designed FemShep was an ass man, not a boob man. I would never run around with male Shep naked. I have my own penis, I don't want to look at another man's. That's just not going to happen. Plus, I had to do all that crap when I was in the army. And being short is the only disadvantage of being in the army, is that anybody over 5'11's penis is in your face.
Captain Atandra here.
Like, unintentionally.
We're on it, Captain.
Good. The Valiant ship is still out there somewhere. We've lost so many, and Matriarch Ashara. It can't be for nothing.
Come on, damn it.
Some engineer left before she could clean up her workbench.
These components were taken from all systems, including power. Distribution.
Explains the problems we're having. How could people be gutting the Ark?
And the other thing that I had to say about the PlayStation, I am a pad guy versus the joystick. I much rather be able to maneuver with the pad versus the joystick. Especially when things like what just happen. My character can get stuck. And at least with the joystick, yeah, I have a little bit more control.
What is it? It's like nails on glass. Looks like an observation deck. For observing the mess they made of the place? People must have evacuated from the deck beyond. Thank the goddess, you're all right. Here, this is what strikes the power.
No.
What is this thing?
I want to know what you guys think. I mean, honestly, I think we deserve a DLC. That's just my personal opinion. I honestly know that we're not getting one, but I do think that we deserve one. As true Mass Effect fans, we definitely deserve something other than a paperback book that I can't seem to find in stores.
And give anyone sensitive to Mass Effect fields a nasty migraine. No kidding. But they'd survive. The deck's deserted now. We have to turn the device off. I tried pulling the plug, but nothing. Can you scan it? Maybe your Sam can figure it out.
The device requires two people for shutdown. One disconnecting the cables, and another at the device itself.
I'll handle the device.
Caution. Once begun, the fail-safe cycle must be completed, or the device will fuse.
Ready, Vidaria? Disconnecting the first cable now.
Think about my other gun, it was more accurate.
They're down. Okay, next cable, ready when you are.
I'm already up here, dear. That's another thing about like computers and PCs and shit. I'm kind of upset if they get all of the good mods and we don't get that shit for Xboxes and PlayStations. You know, which really kind of hurts my feelings because that's how they're running around with them shepping them naked as hell. Alright, it's been scanned. Why can't I disconnect the damn thing? Look at that detail. See the damn hands. Shit. Who's left?
Cut her down.
The device can now be deactivated.
And this has happened in most of the Mass Effect games. I just can't seem to get my characters to line up the way they're supposed to.
If anyone asks,
which really
like
sucks.
Got here.
It's Captain Atandra. Ryder, the drive core's coming online. You did it. A few minutes, and we're out of here.
And I mean, they really, really, really suck.
I'll take a breather once we're at the Nexus.
That's smart. At least sensors are clear for now. Sarissa here. Superb work, all of you. We're almost home.
I have such dry skin on my hands, too.
It's really over. I should go and help. There might be something I can do.
Come on, damn it. For God's sake.
We'll keep an eye on that hull breach, just in case.
Sarissa should be proud, Vidaria. You'll be one hell of a commando.
You'd know, Lieutenant. Thank you for everything. Goddess guide you.
Pathfinder, restoring power has freed up your data cache. It includes the succession log from Matriarch Ishara.
Can you access it?
This would be a part where I would get pissed.
I need you. The barrier's collapsing.
Ishara, they'll tear the Ark apart. That data is the only thing that might buy us time.
Get reinforcements approaching, Pathfinder Ishara.
In my hand, the back of my hands feels just like fucking sandpaper.
My Sam can't.
What the hell's causing that?
Please. I have to
save
them.
That was not supposed to be in the video. That was supposed to be in my head. Looks like your hero is a real bitch.
Tiamna used to mean guardian of temples. A champion who stayed faithful even when all was lost. Sarissa left her to die. What good is a guardian who doesn't defend her Pathfinder when it matters? After everything she wrote on duty, sacrifice. Damn it, All Rider. What do? First, we
deal with that.
Atandra here. The cat hunters blindsided us. They have a dropship headed for the breach on deck 12.
How long until we have FTL?
Too long. Sarissa's coming to help. Push him back.
Helmets on, people.
Come on. Come on, damn it, run. Yeah, like I said, something's wrong with my controller. I'm pretty sure of it.
Caution. The Mass Effect field device is still connected. Remotely triggering it may affect local gravity.
Could be useful.
Keep your mag boots active! And watch the giant hole!
Okay, if he doesn't have any gravity, how did his body fall straight down? Oh shit. I did that.
Ryder, the Valiant's sending more cats. Sarissa's almost there. Don't let up.
You have some words for her? So yeah, you go ahead and send her to us, please. Everybody move! You're the good guy. I'm nobody's minion. I was an Alliance soldier. Peacekeeper, actually. Oh, shut up. Eat a grenade, dick. He's one ugly motherfucker. Throwback to Predator, the original Schwarzenegger. This is not good.
Like the Battle of Kirkus, there's still a chance.
Cora?
Please!
Help your hero. That's right, ladies. Bionic boost that shit. Come on, girls. Do your thing. Girl power, baby. I couldn't resist that. That was about as girlish as I can get. I'm sorry, I did not have a extra feminine voice. Although, once upon a time, I really did. I was really good at voiceovers. I actually fooled a man to believe that his daughter had a girlfriend named Mom. I think that was the name I used. I really don't know, but it was a pretty girly name. And I had to come up with it on the fly.
A skeleton crew.
I did it for
enough to patch up the Ark. She'll make it to the Nexus. Whatever it costs. You need to talk to Sarissa about Ashara's message.
I wanted to thank you both. That was exemplary work. I'm proud to...
Ma'am? Sarissa? We know about Ashara.
The log survived. Then her final moments won't be lost.
You've deserted your Pathfinder. You should be better than...
I chose protecting all these people over a single life. The choice they train us to make, Lieutenant.
But you didn't tell anyone. Because then you wouldn't be their shining hero. And maybe that's how it should be.
Being a Pathfinder means giving them hope. Ryder.
Sadly, this bitch is telling the truth.
They need to hear the truth. Let them handle it.
Ryder, Cora, don't do this.
Sorry, but we need to prep for the Nexus approach. We've got a hell of a story for them.
There's more. Sarissa chose retrieving the Ket data over saving Ishara's life. Our Sam found the succession log.
You've... One of your harebrained ideas got Ashara
killed? The Ket killed her. I had to be sure the Ark could escape them.
And we did. Again and again while they hunted us down. It's only dumb luck that Ryder found us. Who's next in line? Adaria? Maybe a Pathfinder with some humility... can do better. You can look to Ryder's example.
If you want my professional take, I keep Sarissa where she is.
You can't be serious.
You can't afford to lose a Pathfinder with her power and experience.
But if she lets her people down again...
I'll do my job, Atundra. And I'll take the consequences. Don't pretend to know what you're thinking, Ryder. But maybe they'll understand and forgive.
You can survive without forgiveness. They train us for that, too.
So before you guys, before I end this video, I want to let you guys know why I exactly did that. As a fighter, as a veteran, if I was thrust into Ryder's shoes... I'm not sure if I could handle it on a personal note. So, a more experienced person, I would personally gladly step down and let them take the lead. Mostly because, I'm going to be a little bitch about this, I don't want the responsibility. There's a lot that comes with rank. And that's the one thing you guys have to understand.
Can I just do today over again?
War situation. In
and
a military situation.
A hero in front of her entire arc.
Rank is questionable.
I put so much faith in
only
Sarissa.
Some people who aren't
but
really
the
deserve
Asari were just as lost as we are.
Unfortunately, I have Ryder's luck. But if I have a good crew, you know,
so
I'll probably be able to
handle
it.
Of wisdom and experience, huh? Guess we're all just bailing each other out. Thank you for being there on the Lucinia. Can I tell you something?
Sure.
The old man was right to choose you as Pathfinder instead. I don't blaze a trail. I always look for the mentor, the plan. As a Pathfinder, my mistakes would be worse than Sarissa's.
Sarissa?
She lied just to stay a hero. You fight. You save lives. and you don't need applause for doing it. That isn't... It is true. Deal with it. Look, neither of us chose this, but maybe we both ended up where we needed to be, even if we lost your father. But it's happened.
I so want to be a lesbian with Cora.
Gotta use it. What did you... He said something like that once. Still true. I need to think of it, but I'll be okay. And on deck, whenever you need me.
Well, I want to thank you guys for watching. I hope that I got some things off my chest. I think that mostly as I close out, that as I explore the ship, I'll close out. I think that BioWare really should reconsider giving us the DLC. I also want to show you guys this artwork of Koros. So there you go there. Come on, damn it.
Hey, can I see you in the med bay?
Yes, you can, Lexi. Yes, you can. Oh, damn it. Come on. But first, I gotta go find my monkey. Yeah, that's the other thing. The one thing that also pisses me off about, like, the PC versus the game consoles. The PC gets more, you know. Hands down, it gets hours more. It gets more pets. It gets more, because, you know, if you're Shepard, you can get the robot dog. And you can get the hell's the other thing? Besides Boo the space hamster. But you can definitely get the robot dog. Come on, Ryder, damn it. For God's sake.
You have new email at your terminal, Pathfinder.
Yeah, I'm getting there. I also need to go to the Tempest. I mean, the Nexus. So that I can, do the visions. There's my space mouse. I don't know what the hell his name is. I don't remember what the hell his name is. I think it's in the book somewhere. Sid, Cora, let's talk Vetra. Heading home. Come on, damn it. Come on. Open sesame.
Feeling okay?
You asked me to come here.
So how did an Asari doctor end up on the human arc? Specialist in alien anatomy. So
I'm gonna end this here and now.
That includes humans.
I wanna thank you guys for watching.
Also, Harry insisted.
This is Comfort Havoc number 2.
BCNU.